Neeko support. Love it. Interesting. Let's try this again. Wonder if it's like too troll to go mana flow. Nimbus Cloak is pretty broken, but not in this game. It's really not that strong this game. Actually, what am I saying? It's always good. They just don't have that many skill shots. But still good. I think just good on MF. Bum bum bum. They have so many dive. Let's get that, could be a good idea. Excuse me. Let's see. I'm kinda hungry, but I guess I could wait a while. Kinda down to eat, like, I don't know, actually. I'll think about it. Oh, I'm kind of down to eat it like a Thai curry. How about California pita? Alright. Then it's good. Why do I have red? Fuck, I keep forgetting. Actually, it's fine. Maybe it's like good. Genius. Stop touching the creeps, man. Stop touching the creeps, man. Is he charging his W? Is that why he's doing that? What the fuck is that? That was the weirdest shit I've ever seen in my life. Did you guys see that? The minions ignored that creep because it was on the edge of the bush. I've never seen that in my life. My bad, that's free kill. I messed up. So lucky. So lucky. So bad, actually. I don't know. I should have moved my ping before he killed it. I think mana flow is better with exhaust. I get no Nimbus cloak value this whole game. I'd rather just have mana flow. Is he getting fruit? He is, right? Yeah, he's fruiting. So weird, level 4. Like, I feel like I missed so much XP or something. Sad, I should have queued. Yeah, he's full HP now. He's warded here. I get dragged. I'm still freezing though. I like. We're invading. It's good. See their jungler. Really good poke. No, no, stay, stay, stay. Sad. So low. I didn't have Q up there, so otherwise I would have maybe one-shot him. I feel like I'm letting him off super easy here. I should just stay. Here. Fuck. I wasn't really thinking. I already have a pink down. God, yes. Thank God. It's a punish. Wait, it's not a punish. No pink here. Could get TP'd behind by Rengar. Shanka. Not as much as I wanted to. It's enough though. Myself. So if I base. Cat dive. Yeah. That's so good. I like what Adrenaline's doing here. Oh, he's dead then. Wait, what? Wow. Galio is absolutely the most unlucky player I've ever seen. I should have exhausted him right away. I actually didn't realize that was my Galio. Uh-oh. You missed that. Yep, yep. That was extremely sad. Nice. How the fuck is this allowed, by the way? This is so crazy what they're doing, just sending 5 bot and hitting my turret. Mega. Jesus. Oh, that's my bad. Didn't think he'd jump again. Please group for this. They're gonna get 4 dragged when their bot lane's getting shit on the entire game. Let's cause it to actually recall. That'd be kind of crazy. Wow, they're giving it. That's so sick. We should fight their Grump, I think. Oh wow, so dead. Oh, I'd survive for a little bit longer because of the bush, thank god. Oh! Oh, wow. Oh, guys, don't tell me. The Zilean's actually so lucky, what the fuck. And our jungler is literally never grouped. He just is always doing his own thing. So bad. Lucky our team is scaring him. Nice. Now he's just gonna run in and die. He, like, came late. Oh. Flashed. Get out, guys. My buy is super late. Nice, we killed someone randomly. It's actually one thing I learned about playing solo queue is like, it's so valuable to just be there. Your team. I mean, it's like obviously valuable in competitive too, but the thing is that a lot of times in solo queue, teams group for literally no reason. So, competitive, you would not like, you would not just like also group for no reason, you would call them to do something useful, like farm or ward or base or like just wait for you because you it's really good for you. If, like, this guy is a different player when he's playing Neeko, I guess. He's actually hitting every fucking E the entire game. We should just do it. There's literally nothing they can do about it, right? No one has slumps on their team. That's like one thing that's really OP about being blue side. Is if the enemy has no slumps, then this is actually really good to do. Blue side's like got the better angle. I don't have exhaust, unfortunately. Probably gonna play pretty behind my teammates. That was a really good Galio T. Save him. Probably 1v2 them. It's back. Yeah, a million people ask me the same question every game today. It's like, why am I going Pen? I think it's just better than Gale Force. The reason why is because I think Gale Force is sometimes good, obviously, if they have like Malphite, or like if they have Alistar, then you know you get some sick value out of it. But Thresa's AD carries were fine before Gale Force existed, right? They're fine with just playing with Flash and heal, and sometimes fine with just Nimbus Cloak. So my opinion is that you don't need Gale Force ever. You just need position better. There's so much damage here. And Lethality gives you pretty OP stats, all the items. Mostly you get a percentage pen per legendary item, so I'm getting 8% pen instead of 6% move speed, which is way, way better. It's not even close how much better it is. I'm gonna die to Kaisa here. Probably could die if they have TP, but let's get out. Basically, you get a shit ton of good, better stats running, and crit doesn't even do damage anymore anyways. If you're worried about like not scaling with IE, then you just do what I'm doing, which is you go 3 pen items, which is ridiculously better than the Gale Force builds, and then you do IE 3rd, so you're still at 60% crit, because these two lethality items give crit, and then you're still going to end the game at 80% crit, so what's the difference? You just have 20% less crit, but you're doing like 50% more damage because of pen. Like 50% armor pen is like, I don't even know how to explain it, guys. But imagine like someone, let's see, like this guy right here. His armor gives him 39% reduction, but like let's say it's like reducing your damage by 50%. So you're doing half damage. And then lethality and like stacking pen items gets you to like, I don't know, gets it to like 10%. Then you're almost doing double damage, right? The closer you can get the reduction to 0%. It's a crazy multiplier on your damage. Also, I just hate Gale Force move speed. I think it's so useless to have move speed on AD carry. It doesn't do anything. Like, I can one-shot this guy, I'm pretty sure. Oh, he flashed. Oh, Satch. Oh, I'm dead! Wow, I'm actually dead. I'm actually trolling. Like, Zillion's double stun's pretty nuts. Oh! Wow, this Galio is actually playing amazing. Makes sense. The Galio is playing amazing, what the fuck? Every single time I see him, he's just insane. Why is my... Guys, I can't move my mouse. The game is like overriding my mouse. Yeah, I mean, every time he dies in AD carry, it's like, people are gonna say, oh, what if you had Gale Force there? The truth is that you should just play better. Gale Force only really saves you if you, like, play with it in mind, like you have this extra dash, but if you don't, then just play better. You shouldn't build items, like, thinking that you're gonna make a mistake and it'll bail you out. That's definitely not the right way.